is. A story you'll see only on NBC 15. A Sun Prairie family is hoping for the best after 13 are killed, several more injured doing a suicide bombing in Afghanistan. 1 week after the attack, this family is clinging to the phone and praying for positive updates.
Well, I got the call from my daughter at 5:30 last Saturday morning.
It is a Thanksgiving weekend Stephen Heimerl will never forget.
Met with her tearful, hysterical voice, and that's when she told me, "Josh just got hit by a suicide bomber," was her exact words.
Thousands of miles away in eastern Afghanistan, two suicide bombers disguised as police officers make it through three security gates into a police headquarters before detonating their explosive within 20 minutes of each other. Among those injured, 22-year-old specialist Josh Brown from Sun Prairie, a father and a husband.
It's just an empty feeling inside that this had to happen. It's, you know, it's nothing you want to wish on anybody, but, you know, out of all the hundreds, thousands of people there, it's like, you know, why him? Why the one guy I know and care about?
Heimerl, Brown's father-in-law, says Brown was rushed into emergency surgery with penetrating wounds to the head and chest, blunt force trauma to the chest, cuts to his arm and leg, and a collapsed lung. But Heimerl says over the last week, Brown's condition has improved, and his wife Jasmine is now in Maryland by his side.
The doctors in Afghanistan said he's lucky, lucky to be alive.
Family here in Sun Prairie now hope for the best, anxiously awaiting every phone call they get. A veteran himself, Heimerl has once again started to wear his own military ring and says he will every day until Brown is home again.
The same suicide bombers are responsible for killing 13 policemen in the attack.